This is experiment 21. It deals with the reactions of carboxylic acids, amines, and amides. Let's go to the preview sheet. Question number one always is the same. Are there any specific safety alerts given in the experiment? And again, you'll look for those triangular icons to guide you. Question two is always the same, dealing with specific disposal directions. You'll look for the garbage can icons. And most of these questions are pretty straightforward. The answers you'll find by reading the content of the experiment or going into the procedure for the experiment. For example, in number five, it talks about the Alka-Seltzer tablet. You can find the answer to number five by looking in part C in the procedure, step one. Question number seven, how are water-soluble amines detected in solution? Well, amines have an impact upon the pH. That's your clue for that question. And number 10 is maybe the one that would cause you a little difficulty. Under what circumstances will you not have any information concerning your unknown recorded in those two tables? Well, those two tables are in Part E, and you won't test in Part E if you've already shown that you have a carboxylic acid or an amine. Let's go to the data and table, data and report pages. Here in Part A, you're looking at the water-soluble carboxylic acids, and you'll be recording your data here. It asks for the solution pH. Acids, as you know, give lower pH values. That is lower than distilled water. And acids also react with bicarbonate to give off carbon dioxide. So what you'll look for here is there a bubbling or an evolution of gas? That would be a positive test for a carboxylic acid. In Part B, we look at water-insoluble carboxylic acids. You're testing three things, two standards, and then your unknown. And you'll be looking for solubility in water. If something is soluble, that means it forms a solution. And a solution, by definition, is uniform. So you won't see two layers or two different regions. You'll be looking for uniformity. In the last part of this Part B, the result of adding hydrochloric acid, you will look for layering and solid formation. So your comments will use those terms. In Part C, we're looking at the aspirin from Alka-Seltzer. And under the observations, again, you'll look for bubble formation, the evolution of a gas. And is there a solid forming or dissolving? That's the kind of terminology that you'll be using in your observations. Part D deals with amine properties, and it asks for solution odor. Well, that's something you can't do online, and so we've given you the odors. They're listed just before the photos for table 21.4. Solution pH, remember that amines are bases, and so they elevate the pH. Part E deals with amides. Result of adding the sample to red litmus, you'll look for color changes. Specifically, you'll see if the red litmus changes to blue or not. Part F deals with the saponification of benzamide. And again, you're testing with red litmus paper, so you'll look for color changes. You'll see if a blue color forms or not. And in the second part of that, you're adding HCl to the liquid. Does a solid form? That's the question. Part G is where you'll identify the unknown functional group. and it asks for your unknown ID number. This is the number when you're online. You enter Chem at the course site, you enter ChemWeb, and as soon as you enter ChemWeb, it gives you a four-digit number. That's your unknown ID number. Now let's look at the questions at the end of the experiment. Number one describes a situation in which we have a pH of 2.4. Well, to me, that suggests that we've got a carboxylic acid because it's significantly below what distilled water would be. And number two says, suppose a solid unknown is insoluble in water. Which of the following reagents might give you more information? Well, if an unknown is insoluble in water, could be anything. Could be an insoluble carboxylic acid, an insoluble amine, or an insoluble amide. So we really don't know anything. We haven't ruled anything out at that point. I hope that helps you as you select your responses. Three and four, pretty straightforward. Number five says that we have an unknown that has a pH near that of pure water. Well, remember what carboxylic acids, what kind of pH they give, and what kind of pH values are associated with amines. That'll help you. Number six, number seven is the last one, and it says that we've got a structure here, and this compound is saponified. Saponified means that it's reacted with sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide is going to rupture this linkage right here. What would the products be? So I hope you have fun with this experiment. Remember to call or email if we can be of help.